Adding images to frames is one of the most powerful things that you can do to engage your students. To add an image to a Google Jam, you're going to go to the icon over on the left that looks like the square with a mountain. This is our typical icon for adding an image. I'm going to select this, and then I'll be given a variety of options that I can use to bring a picture into my Jam. I can upload from my computer, I can do a Google image search, I can go to Google Drives, or I could also go to Google Photos. Please note, students will not have the option to use Google Photos. We also highly suggest that students do not use Google Image Search. For our purposes, I'm going to go to Google Drive. And once I go to Drive, you'll see I have a variety of options within Google Drive that I can use to get photos. I'm going to go ahead and select Recent and go ahead and pull up this picture. Once I've selected it from the list, I hit the Select button in the lower left-hand corner. Once an image comes into the Jam itself, you'll be able to move it around the screen, resize, rotate, as well as, with the three dots in the upper corner, duplicate it and delete the image. Once an image has been brought into the Jam, you can use the pen tool to annotate over top of the image. Another way that you can insert an image into a frame on Jamboard is by taking a screenshot. Here, I have a PDF of a graphic that I would like my students to complete on the Jam. I'm going to go ahead and take a screenshot, and because I'm on a PC, I'm going to use my Windows Shift S button. This is going to allow me to come in and just snip the part of the screen that I need. This is automatically going to copy it to my clipboard. I can then come into my Jam and use Control V to paste this graphic into my Jam. From here, my students are going to be able to use Post-it notes or the pen tool to annotate and complete this particular graphic organizer.